Hey there, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a 20 minute quickie reformer workout for you. This is a request from Corey. Corey, thank you so much. It's a Sunday and I really need to kick my own butt, so I thank you. Today I'm gonna do kind of my go-to meat and potatoes workout. So I'll mainly be doing basic and intermediate exercises. Since I am me, I will do the overhead at the top, but I am going to include frog and circles, and I'll list all the exercises that I do in this video in the info box below, as well as some blog content about the reformer. And thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more workout videos like this, do become a subscriber, click the bell icon, and you'll be notified every time I publish a new video. But that's enough talk, let's get started. I'm on the Contrology Reformer by Balanced Body, and I'm gonna start actually on two springs for myself for footwork. And I'm gonna start standing. I'm gonna lie back in one motion. Actually, let me just stop for a moment. I'm gonna take this foot bar cover off. I'm gonna start standing again. I'm gonna lie back. Footwork on the balls of your feet, heels together, toes apart, 10 times. And just imagine if Joe Pilates had given us a platform on which to put our feet. Really feel like your heels are also kind of pressing into something imaginary. If you use the foot corrector, you can certainly think of that. It'll just help you stimulate the seat and the back of the legs even a little bit more. After you've done 10, go to the arch position, knees together and feet together. And keep feeling like every time you push the spring, you lift your center in and up to be taller, even though you're lying down. This is number 5. Keep the pressure of the heels. 7, 8, 9, one more. Lift both feet, place the heels on the bar, and go. 2, push into the bar in both directions. Now you get to actually push on something with your heels. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. For the tendon stretch, now push the heels down, lift, 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 lift in the opposite direction, and then push down to lift up. Down, 2, 3, push down, up, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, up, 2. That's kind of hard to count. 4, up, 5, up, 6, up. Really reach the top of the thighs all the way down to the foot bar. 8, up, 9, up. One more time. Slide a little bit away from the shoulder rests, lower the foot bar. I only have 2 springs on, so I'm gonna sit up and add one more spring for the 100. Take your handles. Pretend your legs are still doing exactly what they were doing to the bar in the footwork, and go. Breathe in for 5 pumps, and out for 5 pumps. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just 2 more. Return. Take your handles in one hand, sit up, change back to 2 springs if you're on 3 again, and then get your black straps. We're going to go to frog and circles. Thread the black straps through the handle and the loop. The clips go on the outside. And then I'm going to sit back in one motion. Keep the carriage still. Lift your feet into the straps. And let's do 5 frog and 8 circles in each direction. With your circles, keep the heels, the inner thighs, the bottom together when they are together. 2 more. Reverse. Resist back into your frog. Hold both wooden handles with one hand. Unclip the black straps with your other hand. Take the black straps out, put them behind you. Don't drop anything on your head, and take your headpiece down if you want to join me for the overhead. If you don't, you'll skip it. Just getting that black strap off. You'll skip the overhead and go to coordination if this is an exercise you don't do. Otherwise, you'll join me. And we're going to do 5. Over. Up. Keep the length, roll down. 2 more. Last one. Finish the exercise. Scoop, coordination. Everything stretches out. Reach further, resist, resist and curl. Stretch. Rest your head, hang up your handles, sit up, change to one spring in the middle, get the long box. Place your headpiece up in anticipation of the elephant, and then we're going to do just pull straps and T. And I'm going to undo the knot on my shirt. Pull your stomach in to make yourself as long as you can on the box. And then imagine your shoulder blades drawing down toward the center of the middle back. And reach down to the floor to return. One more time. For the T, reach out to the side. Feel like your shoulder blades are drawing together, again, toward the middle of the upper back. Or even toward the middle of the bra strap area, or the middle back. And then take the straps, place them in the well, step off. Let's take the box away. And now we're gonna set up for the stomach massage. I'm gonna put all my springs on and add a pad. Lift and reach to where you grab onto the carriage. Stand on your foot position with your heels up, and let's go. We're gonna do 10 of this first one. Really make the, take good advantage of the moment of two-way stretch when the heels go one way and your center and lift goes the other way. This is number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One more time, take the spring off in the middle, hands go back. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Get ready to take the spring off. 10, come in, take the spring off, reach up. Push on the bar, lift, 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 lift all the way in. Two more. Reach. Keep your reach even though your hands get further apart. Take a big breath in. Take a big breath out. Lift your feet off, get up without your hands, and then let's go to the short box. Foot bar down, pad with you, headpiece down. You're gonna bring the box, the pole, and the pad to set it up for the short box. While I'm at it, I've got my pole and my pad. I'm gonna set up my handles so that they're ready to do short spinal massage when I finish the short box. I'm gonna tidy my straps while I'm at it. Grab your two straps for the feet. Keep the strap nice and tight. Try to feel like you can stand in that strap, just like you had your feet standing on the foot bar. Stand in the strap, pull in and away from it. And then exhale and push through the heel. Push through the heel and lift in and up. And then push through the heel to come back. We're gonna do three more. One more. And then take the pole, reach up and forward. We're going to do 5. And then stay tall, reach the pole down. Reach the pole back up again. Stretch to the side. Keep standing in your feet. And lift to the center. Exhale. And center. Exhale. And center. Do a total of 3 sets. I can't remember if I did 3, so I'm gonna do an extra, because this is an exercise that I do like to skip. I mean, I don't skip, but I would like to. So I can't be trusted. Reach up, reach through your heels, twist. And then if you do around the world, let's do that as well. So reach up and forward, lift up, twist, reach. Reach in 2 directions, keep reaching in 2 directions, come all the way up. Let's reverse.
And then stow the bar, bring one leg out, stretch it up, sitting nice and tall. Walk your hands all the way to your ankle, lift up and stretch over your leg. Use your stomach and reach your lower body away as you pull back into your position. Keep the lower body going away. Keep you going down toward the box and then pull in and come all the way back up. Reach the lower body away, pull in. Reach up to your toes and reach your heels to the ceiling. And take that ankle across. Lift up and stretch forward. And then we'll do the other side. Stretch. Walk to the ankle. Stretch up and over your leg. Use your bottom to send your lower body away as the stomach pulls in. And then you're just going to keep doing those two things. One more. Walk up to the toes, reach your heel to the ceiling, lift up and forward. And then you'll take that leg across. Lift and stretch over. Use your straps. Step off, let's take everything away, and then we'll come back for the short spinal massage. Also, as a note, if you're in the habit of getting the box and the pole separately, start trying to bring them together because eventually there'll be so many more exercises and you'll be able to squeeze just a few more into that second trip to get the pole. Okay, short spinal massage. Lift up your feet into the straps. Pull your stomach in. And then use your stomach and your bottom to bring the carriage back home. Let's do three more. And then last one. Really reach and take off into the strap. Keep reaching the upper body in that arm position. And then just take your hands and exhale and just bring your knees into your chest. Keep your bottom working. Exhale, 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 exhale. And then take your handles and straps off your feet. Pull on the handle. Put the handles back. So now let's set up for the elephant. Foot bar up, headpiece up. We're gonna do elephant, knee stretches, running, pelvic lift, and then we're gonna do the side splits and the front splits. Here we go. Getting on without moving the carriage. Dig your heels down into the mat. Lift your stomach all the way up to where your hands are. Press out, pull in. Let's actually do six. And then we'll do three on each leg. Keep the carriage nice and still as you change legs. Kneel on the carriage. Place your feet against the shoulder rests. We're going to do 10 of each of the knee stretches. Here we go. Do keep count. Change the arch. Change to the in the air. Three. Come down gently. Add one more spring. Fly all the way back. 10 sets of running. Of the pelvic lift. Seven. Eight. Nine. Be nice to your back on the way down. So let's set up for the side split. I'm gonna take a pad. I'm gonna take one, I'm gonna be left with one spring in the middle. You can also do side splits on two springs. And here we go. Step onto the carriage, step onto the frame with the pad. Arms out, heel toe over to your split. Keep the bottom working. Press out. Hold two, three. Push down. Pull yourself together. Two, three. Press out. Press down. Pull it together. One more like that. Heel toe that foot on the carriage underneath you. Leave room to step your other foot to the carriage. Turn around facing the foot bar. And then we'll set up again across from the pad on the second side. So to the frame, straight legs, heel toe. Find your bottom, because it's only gonna wanna go away. And then press out, hold, two, three. Press down and lift, two, three. One more. I can't really talk and use my bottom at the same time, evidently. That's very interesting. And then heel toe, foot comes underneath you, step to the carriage, and then step down. Let's set up for the front split. Foot bar up. Two springs, a pad. Actually, we don't need the pad. If you wear socks, you could put the pad against the shoulder rests for traction. And then we're going to start with the kneeling version of this exercise. So start with your chest up, lift your stomach in and up, and feel like you're almost doing a one-legged down stretch. You're just going to use the glute to move the carriage out an inch. And you're gonna keep that leg out there, lift your waistline, and drag the carriage in. So you probably feel a big stretch in the hip flexor and or the thigh. And now you're gonna round over your legs, square your center as much as you can, press out. Again, more of the back leg and the back hip going out versus the leg in front straightening. In our order, we have a full split, which is the Russian split after this exercise. So this is an exercise about the hip stretch to enable you to do splits. One more time. Keep everything working, reach up, take a little balance, use your lift to lift up out of your hips, square the bottom. Now rise up on that, lift your knee and put your foot down on the mat. And then we'll do three here. Still resisting the carriage, come in. And then find your balance, reach forward, take your hands behind your head, and find your bottom. Yes, feel like everything that's attached to that carriage is the main mover in the exercise. And then reach forward, scoop your stomach in, and hold onto the bar. Rise up onto your toes so your foot can become parallel to put your knee on the mat so you don't do any funny misaligning of your knee joint. And then we'll go to the other side. Lift up your chest, find your bottom, and then an inch out, and then resist and come in. An inch out, one more. And then round over your legs, resist. One more. Take your balance. Lift, lift, lift. Lift your knee, place your foot on the carriage, and go. Find your balance. Reach forward, hands behind your head. Lift up your knee, place your foot down, place your knee down with your foot in parallel. And then let's just do, that's the end of the reformer workout. Let's just do a tiny bit of rolling, because there's no rolling on the reformer. So push onto the floor, reach your arms up, sit with control. Three ball. Extend your legs. Three of the rocker. Change to the seal, three of the seal. And after this one, you're gonna stand up. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions about the exercises that I did, or ones that I left out, or anything about this workout that I did not mention, please leave me a comment below. I love what's happening in the comments. And thank you so much for watching. I'm a little bit sweaty and it's hard to talk. That's always a good post-Pilates moment. Thank you so much. Love you guys. Bye.